Hey guys, I'm going to show you a really easy glitch that was just found on the Darkest Shore for World War II Zombies. Sledgehammer has been on top of it with patching glitches for this map, and there hasn't been a whole lot of after patches found that are, you know, out of the map, but there is one right here by the Pack-a-Punch. You can see that zombie spawn right there in that opening, and you do a very specific type of jump to get through that opening. It's very easy once you get the hang of it. But the good thing about this one is that, yeah, you can get outside of the map and you don't have to take it down to do it. It's just a simple jump. So you want to stand back about this far right here, and what you're going to do is just walk forward. Do not run. Walk forward, and then you want to jump crouch, and you want to hit that opening where it's like the highest part of your jump. Once you do jump, you want to hit crouch really, really quickly, so it's almost at the same time. It's that jump crouch in that really fast motion, and then, you know, hitting that opening at the highest point of the jump that will get you through it. And you don't need anything special to get through this opening as far as like giving you speed, like stamina. You don't need that at all. You can use it or not use it. It doesn't matter. And I think, you know, holding out any specific type of gun doesn't make a difference either. Once you're in this room, I think you're stuck in it unless you down yourself to get out. There's no way to get out of it other than that. We try to jump back through the opening and it just doesn't work the same. The spawns are a little weird in here. They're going to freeze a little bit on the outside of the zombie spawn, but there will be some that spawn inside with you. And doing this solo, I haven't tried yet, but with two people, yes, some of the zombies will freeze on the outside, but they spawn die really quickly. So if you're just wanting to kill only the ones that are inside of the room, you know, that's easy enough. And a good setup for two people is to have like one person back here at the spawn, and then another person just shooting the few zombies that are outside. And if you've built the ripsaw and brought it with you but not upgraded it, then you're gonna have unlimited killing. It's like the, you know, bayonet style killing. You just stab them, and even the whistling and also the bombers are just like insta-killed by it. The ripsaw is really good for just getting through rounds really quickly and insta-killing every zombie unlimited. It's even more powerful for like leveling up than the sword was on Final Rite. I haven't tested this zombie spawn for how fast it is, but we used to be able to get out of the map and go into the sub pin area, and there was like one zombie spawn, and if you use the ripsaw with its unlimited killing, you could get to Master Prestige if a double XP event was running in 1 day 6 hours. I don't know if this zombie spawn stands up to the speed of the sub pin area. I'm still testing that, and I'll definitely let you guys know. I know people are still looking for after patches to get, you know, further out of the map and into the sub pin and areas like that, so I'll definitely let you know if somebody finds something. But I hope this helped you guys out, and we'll see you next video.